If you haven't watched the previous Fresh Meat video, please go do so. It's a very interesting game, the last one. This one contrasts with the last game. Even though I'm up against an Anarch again, this shows you what happens if you're the runner and decide to float tanks from mid seasons. Yep, spoiler alert. So, let's get down to the game. Once again, my opponent establishes a quick, is able to catch up in terms of credit differential against me very quickly. In the arena game, in the last game, what happened was he got a Lamprey and sucked one credit per run. This time he gets a Desperado out and he gets one extra credit per run, which is pretty good. So that is pretty awful and it forces me to play differently. I now have to play a bit more loosely, which means chucking the build into Archives, because if I keep it in hand, he will definitely fetch it on the HQ run. The good thing is that I actually force him to face check all my remotes. Because he suspects that one of them is an agenda, sensing that I have no ice, and because of that I'm trying to sneak out an Astro Script or something. Turns out that's not the case. All I'm doing is installing pet campaigns, which is pretty good for him. He's Valencia, he has a Desperado. 4 trash cost suddenly becomes minus 2 for him, which is very good compared to most other runners. So I would say he definitely wants to trash them as Valencia. Since he face checked them, I think he could have afforded to trash both of them, but he chose not to. And I think that would be a mistake. He chose not to trash the second pet campaign in the end, so I've rescued it from my heap and I rest it. He's not going to deny my economy, which is very bad news, because that will just make my mid-seasons grow out of hand and I already have them in hand. So at this point, I don't really care. Even if he runs my archives to steal the bill, I'm going to mid-seasons him down. He only has 3 clicks worth of ult because he's playing more outside. So the chances of him recovering from taking a stray tag is very low. The only problem is I don't have any tag punishment in my hand just yet. So until I find tank punishment, I cannot do anything crazy like fast track or breaking news. I need to find my black cards first, and that means drawing up. So the right move for me here would be to draw up with Jackson, which I definitely do. That's the right move here. I do not find anything good. All I find is more agendas. So here I do the obvious move of installing the TGTBT, which is an agenda I don't want to score. In fact, I want the runner to score it, steal it for me, so that it turns on mid-seasons. And gives him a tag while at it. Perfect. He ate the bait. But he's now much richer because he played Show Gamble as his first click before running. So with 2 clicks left, he stole the agenda. He runs my hand. There's nothing in there. Don't worry. And for his last click, he has 12 credits to my 15 credits. He takes a credit. Smart move that avoids the mid-seasons. Not really. Because he did not contest my pet campaigns, I have 17 to his 13, so I can easily trace him. The question is, how many tags do I trace for? I don't really want to spend all my money at this point because I'm pretty sure he will just float tags. So what I do here is to trace 15. He will have to take 2 tags if he wants to avoid, at best, if he wants to clear the tags. Here, he does not choose to do so. And I promptly kill his adjusted chronotype, which is a very good decision, leaving him with 3 clicks left for the rest of the game. Now, one big mistake he made was not clearing the tag after stealing TGTBT. I mean, it's a good thing if he wanted to avoid the mid-season trace, but otherwise, that left him vulnerable to scorch shelf and close accounts, which was a very bad idea. I definitely disagree with floating the tag on TGTBT unless he had the intention to beat my mid-season's trace as hard as he could. So yeah, that was a problem. That was something that was pretty problematic, and either way he was losing his adjusted chronotype. So I don't think that's worth losing. Having only 3 clicks per turn really punishes you. And he is going to pay for that dearly. Even though he draws 2 new cards every turn, having 3 clicks means that it's much more easier, it's much easier for me to control him, because I know that he can only do so much during his turn. So I'm going to let him run through all my servers because I don't really care at this point. All I want to do is to find the black cards. So even if he steals an Astro script, there's no big deal because I'm not planning to score the Astro script anyway. My win condition is now solely focused on flatline since I've landed the mid-season trace. So I actually do want him to steal agendas because this means I will draw the black cards from R&D faster. I'm still not seeing them, so obviously, usually I would draw with Jackson here, but now I want to keep him from winning on R&D because two more agendas and he wins the game. So I get a quandary going on R&D, removing the Gutenberg, which is now rendered useless for obvious reasons. He collects money and makes a pretty good, he does a smart thing, which is to hit Liberated twice because he knows that I can very well burn it. By destroying it since he's tagged. But I don't really care because he's too rich at this point. So there's no point denying him the 8 Liberated credits. So on the next turn, he takes all the money from Liberator and stalls Data Sucker. Now I've already drawn into 4 meat damage worth of cards. It's looking good, and I do have enough money to play Scorched Earth, but I don't have the Scorched Earth. So at this point, I'm going to ice up HQ with a pop-up window, and Archives will wrap around. I suspect the keyhole is coming, and there might be some other nasty tricks that he has up his sleeve. He could be playing Wanton Destruction, he could be playing Imp. And the last thing I want him to do is to destroy my black cards. That will be very disruptive and is a big counter to my deck. So I'm trying to get this game going as fast as I can, and the Aether confirms it. He's playing Keyhole. So I need to secure R&D very well. The single quandary won't do. I'm going to put the wraparound over it because once the keyhole comes on the board and he starts milling my Scorched Earths, I could be in trouble. But I've found 6 meat damage worth of cards. It's pretty risky though. Do you play the traffic accidents at this juncture knowing that he might be running I've had worse? If I hit even one I've had worse, my traffic accidents are wasted. And here, hilariously, he misses the traffic accident. So he hasn't actually realized I'm playing Butcher Shop. He hasn't hit any of my black cards yet. So I'm looking at his heap. There are no I've had worse. And he's drawn through a sizable portion of his deck. I'm just going to take the risk here. If I hit an I've had worse, I'll just keep drawing until I find a Scorched Earth. I play 2 traffic accidents. None of them hit I've had worse, which means I win with the final traffic accident that hits his hand while he only has 1 card left in his hand to close the game. You don't fear I've had worse. You just play your meat damage. If it hits I've had worse, back up, reset. That's the way to go about it. It slows you down, but with Jackson Howard in the game and 6 black cards in your deck, including 3 Scorched Earths, sooner or later, you will draw into them and you will be able to do more damage than I've had worse can rescue them. And yeah, because of that, I managed to win. You do not want to float tags against Butcher Shop unless you are very close to victory and you can pull out a 7-point win in the next few turns. He definitely could have cleared the tags even if it meant sacrificing a lot of tempo. It would have turned off my main win condition, because it is nearly impossible for me to score against Valencia knowing that he has blackmail. Instead, he chose the risky route and definitely paid the ultimate price for it. Thanks for watching. Happy Netrunning. Goodbye.